Hello friends, I'm Naishik from blogdude.com, and today in this reality show, how to create a website header similar to websites like Amazon, Flipkart and AliExpress. Now if you see these three websites, these are the biggest e-commerce websites in the world. Amazon is biggest in US, Flipkart is biggest in India, and obviously AliExpress is the biggest e-commerce website in China. So if you see all these three websites, so first let's see Amazon. So in Amazon, as you can see at the left hand side, you have this logo. In the middle, you have this nice big search bar. At the right hand side, you have this cart icon. And at the bottom, or sometimes at the top, you have few links. Now similarly on Flipkart as well, at the left hand side, you have this logo, big search bar in the middle. Right hand side, you have the cart icon and few icons or few buttons. And at the bottom, you have the menu icons or menu links. And similarly on AliExpress as well, left hand side logo, big search bar in the middle, right hand side cart icon, and at the bottom few menu links. So we'll also create a very similar header. In fact, this is the exact same header that we'll be creating in this video. As you can see at the left hand side, you have your logo, nice and big search bar in the middle. Now obviously, because it's an e-commerce website, people will come to your website, they are searching for some product, so we need a big search bar over here. Then at the right hand side, you have the cart icon. When you click on the cart icon, and when you click on that cart icon, as you can see at the right hand side, it will display all the products that is available or that is added in the cart. What is the subtotal? And if you want, you can just click on this button to view the cart, or if you want, you can just click on checkout to do the checkout. Then after that, we have another icon over here. So if you click on this icon, you will be redirected to my account page. Then at the bottom, we have this hamburger icon. When you click on that, we have some important links over here. And at the right hand side, we have our main menu. And obviously, this is 100% mobile and tablet friendly. If you see this website in mobile phone, as you can see, this is how your header will look like. It is automatically adjusted for mobile phone. And if you see the same website in iPad or in tablet, this is how it will look like. Okay, so as you can see, this is 100% mobile and tablet friendly, and we'll be using Elementor to create this header. Alright guys, so without wasting any time, let's get started. Now first of all, if you see this e-commerce website, this complete beautiful e-commerce website that you see on the screen, as you can see, let me just give you a quick glimpse. As you can see, amazing and beautiful e-commerce website. If you click on a single product, this is how the single product looks like. If you click on the shop page, let's see the shop page. This is how your shop page looks like, and this e-commerce website has all the important features, all the essential features that a professional e-commerce website must have. Here you can do the checkout, you can add to cart any product, you can do a lot of things over here. You can even accept payments right on your website because this website has free SSL certificate. Now if you want to create an exact same e-commerce website for absolutely free, using only free themes, free plugins and free page builder, there is a link given in the video description below, or you can do one thing, you can go to YouTube and search for Naishik e-commerce 2020, or if you're watching this video in 2021 or 2022, you can type in that date, and the first video, that is the video that you should be watching, how to create a free e-commerce website with WordPress online store 2020. In this 2 hours 50 minutes video, I have explained everything in detail, how to create a professional and beautiful e-commerce website using only free resources. So if you don't already have an e-commerce website, or if you don't like the design of your e-commerce website, you can watch this video and create an amazing e-commerce website for free. Alright guys, now let's start creating this header. So first of all, we need Elementor for this. So if you're not already installed and activated Elementor, you can go from the left hand side, hover over appearance, click on add new, and over here you can search for Elementor page builder. Just type in Elementor in search plugins and make sure you have installed and activated this plugin, Elementor page builder. Now with the free version, you cannot do this thing, you cannot create a custom header, you cannot create a custom product design and shop design. So to do that, you need Elementor premium version, and to get that premium version, open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/elementor. Obviously this link is also given in the video description below, so you don't even have to type in this thing. Simply click on that link and you should be redirected to this page. Now as you can see, there are three different plans available, $49 for one website. If you want to use this premium version on one website, you have to pay $49, $99 if you want to use this on three different websites, and $200 for using this on 1000 websites. So whatever plan, all the features are same in all the three plans. The only difference is the number of websites you can use them on. So whatever plan suits you best, just purchase that. And after that, you will have all the theme builder and WooCommerce builder functionalities on your website. So once you do that, come back to your dashboard. Now from the left hand side, you'll see this option templates. Click on that option. Now over here, you have to click on add new. And over here, you have to select what do you want to create? What type of section do you want to create? If you want to create a custom footer, you can select that. If you want to create a custom product design, custom single product layout, you can do that. So in this video, we are focusing on header. Now later on in coming weeks, I'll be creating more videos on how to create a custom design for single product, for product archive page, for blog page, for pop-ups. In this video, we are focusing on header. So select header. Now you can name it anything. I'll name it header 3. Now click on create template. Now when you click on create template, there are so many different pre-made header layouts available for you. So if you want to use any one of these, you can simply select that and click on insert. So let's see what happens if you click on insert. If you click on this, if you select this option and click on insert, you will have this entire design in front of you. As you can see, if you don't like this design, simply cut this thing. And in this video, we'll focus everything from scratch. So we'll see everything from scratch step by step. So first of all, what we want to do is, as you can see here, first we have this, we have two sections. We have a top section, then we have the bottom section. So to create a new section or to create a new row, you click on this big plus button, this red plus button. Click on that. Now you have to select the number of columns that you want in that section. So here, as you can see, we have logo. This is one. Then we have the search bar. This is two. Then we have two icons plus two. So we need four columns over here. So I'll select this four columns. When you select four columns, all the four columns are of equal size. Now what I want to do is, because obviously the size or the width for this logo is smaller, and the width and the size for this search bar column is quite bigger, and these two are again smaller. So first we need to restructure this thing properly. Now the first section, the first column, I want this to be 14%. How you can set that? You can click on this option, edit column, and here you will see column width. Set that to 14%. Then we have the second column, click on edit column and set this to 77%. Okay, if this thing does not work like this, you can set it like this. You can, you know, drag and drop it like this. And let's see. Second one should be 77. Obviously, you can make it 75, 74 as well. I'm just selecting the same amount or same structure that I've selected in the demo website in this header section. So first is 14, second is 77. Now the third is 5%. Now when you do it like this, as you can see the percentage, and the last one, whatever percentage is left. Okay, so first section 14%, second column 77%, third column is 5%, and whatever is left around 3.9 or 4%, that is the last column. Now before we add anything in these columns, first let's add this background color to this section. Let's give this background color to this section. To do that, you can do one thing. You can click on this option, edit section. If you don't see this edit section option, you can click on this navigator, which is at the bottom left. When you click on that, you will see section. When you click on section, at the left hand side, as you can see, you have settings related to edit section. So if you don't see this option, if you don't see this edit section button at the top, you can do this navigator thing. Now what you have to do, click on style from the left hand side. Now we have to give it a background color. You can add a color in the background, you can add an image in the background, or you can also add video and gradient in the background. Let's see all of those options. First of all, click on classic, and if you want to add a single color in the background, you can select any color like this. And if you want to add some image, you can select any image of your choice. Maybe let's try to add this image. Select this image, click on insert media now as you can see, and let's set this size to cover. Now we have that image in the background. Obviously, we don't want to do that. I want to add gradient color in the background. So I'll select the second option, gradient color. Now as you can see, gradient is a combination of two colors, and this is how it will look like. Now I want to set first color as this color, and second color, maybe let me select, yeah, this color. This looks good. And I want to change the direction, and I want to change the angle. Right now it is 180 degree, which means that one color is at the top, another at the bottom. I want to make it left and right. So first color should be at left and second one should be at right. So I'll change this angle to maybe something like this. You can see that on your screen. I think 160 looks great, so I'll keep it to 160, and after that you can click on publish. Whenever you make any changes, you can click on that publish button. Now when you click on that publish button, it will ask you to add a condition. You can add the condition right now, or you can add it later on. We'll do that later on. For now, just click on save and close. Now let's start adding those elements. First of all, at the left hand side, we want to add this logo. Okay, this logo. So whatever your site logo is, select this option, drag and drop this site logo element at the left hand side. Now, whatever your logo is, it will automatically display that logo. Now, what you have to do is, we want some custom padding at left and right. Okay, maybe we'll do that later on. First, let's add all the elements. Now, in the middle element, we want to use this search form element. So, we'll drag and drop this over here. This is how it will look like. Now, this looks a little bit different than the one we have over here. So, let's style it. Let's redesign it. First of all, if you want to change the icon and everything, you can do it from here. Instead of icon, if you just want text. Now, as you can see, this says search over here instead of some icon. We want icon over here, so I'll select icon. Now, according to me, the height of this search bar is quite big, so I'll decrease the size. By default, the size is 50, make it 35. Okay, now this looks much better. When you decrease the size, the size of this button also decreases. So let's fix this thing. To fix this thing, go to style. Now over here at the bottom, you will see button. Click on button. Now over here, you can set an icon size. So for this icon, I want this size to be 26 pixels. Now as you can see, the icon size is increased. Now I also want to increase the width of that. So we'll do it like this. And whatever width you like, I'll set this to maybe 2 over here. Okay, this looks much better. After that, you can click on update. Click on save and close. So whenever you make any changes to your website, you should always update that page. Now we need to add that cart icon. So again, we'll come back over here. We'll select this option menu cart. Drag and drop this cart icon over here. Now this will look totally different on this. Right now, as you can see, this is not looking good. So let's fix this thing. So to fix this thing, first of all, I don't want to show this subtotal. As you can see, right now it is displaying this subtotal. So 1600 or whatever price which is available in the cart, it is displaying that subtotal. I don't want to do that, so I'll make this thing off. I want to hide this subtotal. Now for the icon also, there are different types of icon like cart icon, basket icon, bag icon, whatever icon you like. Just select this solid version of that icon. We have the cart light, cart medium, cart solid. Similarly for basket also, we have basket light, medium and solid. So just select this solid version. So I'm selecting cart solid. Now go to style. First of all, let's change the color of that icon. So here you have icon color. Change this to white. Now, if you see, this is how it will look like. I don't want that border that is looking really bad, and I also want to increase the size of this icon. So I'll come back over here, border width, make it 0. That border will disappear. Okay, just make it 0. Now, as you can see, that border is gone. Again, come back over here. Now let's increase the size. So for this size, I want to make it 27 pixels. And let's see, this is how your icon will look like right now. Now after that, what we want to do is we want to add that last icon over here at the right hand side column. So for that, we'll use this simple icon option. So I'll drag and drop this icon option at the right hand side. We'll change this icon to user icon. Search for user. There will be so many different icons. I want to select this one. So I'll select this, click on insert. Now let's change the style of this. So go to style, change the color to white. Size of the menu cart icon was 27, so size of this also should be 27. Okay, this is how it will look like. Now this is not properly aligned, as you can see, so let's fix this thing. So to fix this thing, we can go to advanced and we can add some padding. So select this padding option. From top, we can add maybe 10 pixels. Now as you can see, this is looking much better. And let's add some padding at left hand side. So I'll select this left. We'll select 5 pixels over here. Let's see it again. Maybe 10 at left as well. So let's select 10. Okay, now as you can see, this looks much better. Obviously, if you want, you can do some more changes over here. Maybe I want to do one thing. I want to add maybe instead of 10, I want to add 12 pixels at top padding. Okay, now this looks so much better. Now we can click on update again, click on save and close. We can also change the color of this, as you can see, color of this icon and also color of that background. So I'll click on that because I think we have changed that in the demo website, as you can see the color of that. So I'll go over here, I'll go to button. I'll change the background color maybe to this blue color. Now as you can see, that color is changed. After that, click on update, save changes. Now we want to add another section. So for that, again, we'll click on this plus button. In this section, we want two columns. So I'll select two columns. Now the left column should obviously be smaller and the right column will be bigger. So I'll select this option, edit column, change the column width to 15%. Now as you can see, this is 15% and this is 85%. Now first of all, at the left hand side, we want the nav menu. So you will see this option nav menu, drag and drop it over here. And by default, this is how it will look like. We want to change the layout. We want to make it drop down so that we get this hamburger icon. And if you want to make it full width, you can do that as well. For now, we can just leave it like this. As you can see, when you click on that, it will display it like this. Now I want to change the style of this hamburger icon. So I'll go to style. Now this is for the drop down setting. We don't want to do anything in the drop down. We want to change this toggle button. So go to toggle button, change this color to black. Okay, so it will change that hamburger icon color to black. And we don't want that gray color, background color. We want transparent background. So I'll do one thing. There are two lines over here. As you can see, one line, this will change the color. So if you select the first line, if you change it, it will change the color. And the second option is to change the transparency. Make it zero. Just bring it to the extreme left. This will become transparent. All right. And for this icon also, you can change the icon size. If you want, you can change this to 27. So that it looks something like this. If you want. Okay, if you want, you can just leave it like this. Now for the second menu. This time also we'll use the same option, nav menu. Now this was another menu. As you can see, if you see in the content, I have created multiple menus. Footer 1, footer 2, main menu, top bar. So this is footer 1. Now in this right hand side thing, I'll add the same option, nav menu. But this time, instead of footer 1, I'll select main menu. Here I want to display my main menu. Now this time the layout will be horizontal. We don't want to do anything over here, but we'll change the alignment. Instead of left, right, center, we'll select stretch so that it stretches to this entire thing, entire width. And I don't want any pointer. When you hover over that, as you can see, you have this green color underline. I don't want that. So I'll change this pointer to none. I don't want any pointer like that. And also change this breakpoint. Just make it none. Because for mobile and tablet, we'll create totally different menu. We don't have anything to do over here. So just change that to none and click on update and save and close. Now let's fix this text. So for that, we'll go to style, change the typography. So for this font family, I want this font family to be Poppins. So I'll go to font family, click on font family and search for Poppins. I'll select this option, change the weight to 500, make it a little bit lighter. And also we'll change this color to black. Right now it is gray color. I want to change this color to black color, something like this. Now you'll see vertical padding over here. Just type in 5 pixels. Just type in 5 over here. Now I want to do one thing. The height of this second option or the second section is quite big. I want to decrease this height. So for that, you'll click on edit column, go to advance and make padding 0. Okay. Similarly, go to second column, click on edit column, go to advance, make padding 0. Okay. This is how it will look like. Then after that, you can do one thing. You can select this option, edit section. And you can make sure that vertical align is set to middle so that everything is aligned in the middle, whether it's this hamburger icon or whether it's this menu. And after that, click on update. Now we can add a condition, and the condition will be to show this thing, to display this header on the entire website. Obviously, you can display this only on WooCommerce or some other thing. I want to display this header on entire website. Click on save and close. Now, if you again go back to your website and refresh it, now this will display this header. Okay, as you can see, now it is displaying this header that we have just created. Now let's see how this header looks like on a mobile phone. It is very important to see how your section, how your website, how your header looks on a mobile phone. Because most of the people, according to Google survey, most of the people will be visiting your website. Sometimes around 60-70% of your website visitor will be from a mobile phone. So we should always see how this looks on a mobile phone. So for that, we'll click on this responsive mode, which is given at the bottom left. Click on mobile. All right, now as you can see, this is totally messed up. It looks really bad. Now what I want to do is I want to hide both these sections on mobile phone. So I'll select this section, click on edit section, go to advance, go to responsive, and I'll select this option, hide on mobile phone. For second section as well, go to advance, select responsive and click on hide on mobile. Now for mobile phone, I want to create a completely different menu. Obviously, it will be very much similar to this, but it will be mobile friendly. Now click on update. So to create the menu on the mobile phone, we'll follow the same procedure. First, we'll click on this option, add new section. And this time also, we want 4 columns. You can just select 3 if you have. You can add more like this. Right click over here, click on add new column. I think we want 5. Yeah, we want 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and one more. Right click on edit column, click on add new column. Now, right now, all the columns are on top of each other. First, let me show you how this looks on a mobile phone. Let's open this on mobile phone. Okay, this is all messed up because our demo website is gone. So I want to make it mobile friendly. What I want to do is I want to change the structure of this. I don't want everything stacked on top of each other. I want everything besides each other. So what I'll do is I'll change the content width for column width for these options. So for first column, I'll click on edit column. I'll make it 45%. This is for logo. At the left hand side will display the logo. For second column, I'll click on edit column. I'll make it 10%. This is just space. We will not be adding anything in this 10% column. This is just some empty space in between. Then for all the three columns, we'll set that to 15%. For this 15%, then we'll select this option, 15%, and another option, 15%. So you just have to make sure that if you total all those percentages, it should be 100 or less than 100, so that you can display all of them in one single line. Now at the left hand side, I want to display the logo. So I'll select this option, site logo, drag and drop it over here. This is how it will look like. Now, because our logo is white, I cannot see that. So first, let's give this section a background color. So I'll click on this option, edit section, go to style. Similarly, for you can go to gradient, you can select all the colors. If you want for mobile phone, you can select totally different color if you want. All right. So whatever color you like, select that color. Again, for angle, I'll change this thing to something like this. Maybe 150 looks good. Click on update. Now I'll change or I'll decrease the size of this logo. This is looking quite big. So I'll select edit site logo, go to style and maybe make it 93%. All right. Now, as I said you earlier, this second column will be empty. So we'll just leave it. Now third column. Now in the third column, I want to add my cart icon. So I'll select this menu card, drag and draw. Or maybe we can do one thing. Let's just unhide this for now. We had selected hide on mobile for top and bottom. Let's just unhide them for now for first section as well. Because right now we can just use this. We can save some time. We can copy, paste it over here. This will save us a lot of time. Now let's fix the padding for this. So I'll click on this plus button. I'll click on this pencil button. Because as you can see, this is going towards right side. We have a lot of space at left hand side. So we want to fix this. So to do that, go to style. And here you will see padding. Here it is. Make it 0 for now. Okay, this is how it will look like if you set padding to 0. Now, if you want you to set some custom padding for top or bottom, maybe for top, if you want 5 pixels or 2 pixels or 3 pixels, you can do it like this. Or if you want, you can just leave that to 0. Then after that, we want to display that user icon. So I'll copy it, paste it over here. Just select paste. And for this also, we need to fix everything. So I'll go to advanced. And make the padding 0. Okay, this is how it will look like. Okay, perfect. Maybe for cart icon, we can add some padding at top. It all depends on you. Now we'll select this option, or maybe we will do one thing. We'll add this option nav menu at the right hand side. Okay, this is how it will look like. Let's fix this thing. So first of all, I want to make it full width. Why do I want to make it full width? Because right now, if anyone clicks on this, this is how it will display and they cannot see properly. And if you set this thing to full width, now as you can see, they can see the menu properly. So that is why we want to make it full width. And for this option, let's see. We have to go to style. First of all, let's change this toggle button. Select toggle button, change the color to white and change the background color to transparent. Okay, just like this. Click on update. This is how it will look like. If you click on this hamburger icon, it will display your menu. And make sure under content, your main menu is selected over here. If you have created multiple menus, make sure main menu is selected over here. Now what we can do is we can add one more column over here. So we can click on edit column. We can right click on edit column, click on add new column. And we want to make it 100% width because we want one complete column over here. Now we can select this search bar, right click on that, click on copy, right click over here, click on paste. Now, as you can see, because of just copying, pasting, we have saved a lot of time over here. And this is how it will look like. Now, at the end, we can select top first and second section. We can hide them on mobile phone. Similarly, for first section as well, hide them on mobile phone. Now, if you update this page, if you come back over here, refresh your website. Now, as you can see, this is all messed up. So what we have to do, we have the one that we have just created for mobile phone. We have to hide that on desktop and tablet. Okay, so this section, select this edit section that we have just created for mobile phone, go to advanced, select responsive and hide this on tablet and desktop because we want to display this only on mobile. Click on update, come over here, refresh it. Now, as you can see, both that thing is hidden. And if you see this on mobile phone now, let me just make it 100%. Okay, now as you can see, that first and second section is hidden. And now we are seeing the one which we have created only for mobile phone. And this looks amazing. Okay, so this is 100% mobile friendly. Now, finally, which is not really important, which is tablet, but let's fix that as well. So let's go to tablet. Almost perfect, just some changes here and there. So let's do that very quickly. So first we need to change the layout for tablet. So in tablet, what I want to do is, first option is edit column. I'll make it 15%. Second option, I'll select second option or second column. I'll make it 70. Then we'll select the third column, edit column. We'll make it 7. And for fourth also, we'll make it 7. All right. Let's see. This is how it looks like. If you want to make some changes, you can do that. If you want to increase or decrease the size of anything, you can do that as well. Click on update. Now, if you click on this icon, this is how it looks like. So I want to fix this thing. For second option, for second section, I want to increase or I want to change the structure to 25% and 75%. Okay, like this. And if your text looks like this, you can change the, or you can decrease the size of this text. So click on this pencil button. Go to typography and decrease the size of your text to 12 or 13 so that it all comes in one single line. So I'm just setting this to 12. Also, I want to make sure the background color of this section is white, not this blue color. So we'll go to edit section, go to style and make sure the background color of this is white. Right, guys, so with this is also completed. Right now it is looking messed up, but this is just for Elementor. If you see this on live website, it will look perfect. Let me show you. First, come to your website, refresh it. And if you just see this on tablet, let's see how it looks like. Now, as you can see, it looks perfect on tablet as well. If you click on this, if you click on your cart icon, everything looks perfect. If you again go back to mobile phone, Pixel 2 or some other device, it looks perfect. If you come back to desktop, you know, as you can see, it looks amazing. Alright guys, so this was a very short video. I just wanted to cover, because many people have requested me, they want to create a very similar design or very similar header like Flipkart and Amazon. So this is how you can do it. So I hope you find this video helpful. If you guys find this video helpful, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any future notifications. Give a thumbs up to this video, share it with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, different social media platforms. If you have any doubts, any comments, any suggestions for me, any recommendations for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thanks a lot for watching this video, guys. See you in the next one.